To your country direct to learn more.
We thought we had planned carefully for our retirement.
But we quickly realized we needed a way to
sell your policy to help with our retirement.
I'm Sim Mam, so I did some research and called Country Direct.
Keeping up what it's worth, visit countrydirect.com and find out if your policy qualifies. Or call 1-800-651-0200. Country Direct, redefine
your life. What? Hello?
I need to bring her back.
Prescription skincare delivered straight to your door. Now that Muesli is out there, I just see a confident young woman.
See for yourself at muesli.com/TV.
EU officials tell CNN that they will likely block most US travelers from coming to their country. It is a stunning turnaround from mid-March, when President Trump banned European travelers from coming to the US. Europe was then seen as being at risk of having an out-of-control outbreak. Now that risk is right here in America. How did this happen? Joining me now is Holly Jung from the University of Michigan School of Public Health. Holly, we've all seen versions of that on the chart, right, where the European cases, EU cases, it's going down, clearly flattened the curve, more than flat. And in the US case, the curve never went flat and is now rising again. What do you think fundamentally explains the disjuncture between those two lines, the European line and the American?
Well, I think there's a couple of reasons behind what we see here in terms of the very different experiences between the US and European countries when it comes to the first wave of COVID-19. First of all, political leadership really matters, especially the ability of central governments to bring everyone together and to coordinate responses. I mean, even across regions that there are countries, but also coordinating responses between the different systems that we figure for dealing with the pandemic, so healthcare, public health, and also systems or social support for people.
So you just said a number of things. So let me piece those out. The first one you talked about was centralization. We understand that the US has a crazy quick patchwork of center, state, local, in thousands and thousands of different countries. The second you said was about healthcare, public health. Now, here I want to drill down. Who is this supposed to have a great public healthcare system? If Johns Hopkins ranked it the best in the world, we think of the CDC and the NIH as being these jewels. Is what you're saying that we have consistent?